Hey guys, how are we doing? Quick update about EURAUD. That was a video posted about, I believe, a month ago. I'll post the link below in the description so you can go ahead and check out the original video here. So just wanted to update you what's going on. Basically the most recent price action, what does it tell us? At least what does it tell me? Now we had this level, right? And that's the huge range we're dealing with and so on and so forth. This is where we had those two fibos giving us that zone. Okay, and that zone is 164, let's say, a round number here. Basically, many people would start selling on the two candle patterns or whatever your idea or reason would be right here. That means once the fibo levels were reached, these guys are now kicked out from their stop losses, with their stop losses, right? And this is where on the 4-hour chart we start getting something that reminds, before this candle of course, something that reminds a breakout, right? It stops, then breaks, and then boom, momentum. However, for most people that could be and would be a trigger for breakout and continuation, but we know how to spot breakouts from false breaks, and in that case we have all the reasons to believe this is going to be a false break. Now in about 15 minutes this candle is going to close, confirming here an engulfing, and ideally we're going to get the price below the 63.50 zone. This is the dashed line, basically, right? The strong support zone. And at the end of the day, I would also like to see the daily chart ticking down the MACD, creating this divergence, completing this divergence, to be more accurate. In other words, that could be an ideal and awesome moment for us to go ahead and start looking for aggressive entries based on divergences, let's say, on the 4-hour chart. And if you want to be more conservative, of course, you should be looking for another setup, okay, which would be basically break below these levels here, break below that zone, to confirm a more conservative idea. That's about EURAUD. Everything is inside the plan, okay, we're still here, we don't have any breakouts. Looks great. This is really happening very rare, guys. It's weekly, daily, all of that, the higher time frames coming to the same place, and we have really a monster opportunity to make some very good cash. And of course the exposure is pretty tiny, right? We can always use stop loss here that are not too big compared to the potential profits that we have, the final profits. Another one very quickly I'm going to include here is the Euro Kiwi. Let's just remove all that for a second. This is where we wanted to see the spike being reached. Okay, we did reach it, the divergence. Now in this case we have the histogram already ticking down. Of course we need to see how the day is going to end. That's nothing at that stage, it's the candle is still developing, but it looks good, right? Level. Furthermore, on the 4-hour chart, this is where we have that cycle was completed. Two false breaks, two divergences, beautifulness. Aggressive entries already live triggered with the break of that low. Conservative entries triggered here. Of course, we're going to have divergence entries and so on and so forth. But this thing, I'm looking for sell opportunities here as well. And of course, don't forget we're dealing with two euro pairs. Okay, strongly correlated, which means don't overexpose yourself to too many euro pairs at the same time, guys. That's what I'm trying to say. That would be all. Don't forget to follow us in our Telegram channel where we have where we post basically three ideas there on daily basis, me and Vladimir Rybakov. Join us in the Traders Academy Club if you're looking for quality education. That's the place. We have live rooms on daily basis. We have trade reports covering pretty much all interesting opportunities, again sent on daily basis. And if you have any questions regarding those two setups, please leave your comment below. I'll be happy to reply. Bye for now.